Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Naveen and I am part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. We have covered the BLE Mesh concept in depth through several Learn Technology in 5 Minute videos already. In this video, we will take a look at the 5-step provisioning process in BLE Mesh. The provisioning process is one of the most important concepts in BLE Mesh. It is used for adding devices to the mesh network. A device that gets added to the network is called a node, and the device used to add a node to the network is called the provisioner, usually a tablet, smartphone, or a PC. The process involves 5 steps. Step 1. Beaconing. Step 1 involves what is called beaconing, where the unprovisioned device announces its availability to be provisioned by sending the mesh beacon advertisements in the advertisement packets. This is a new type of advertisement data type introduced in the BLE Mesh standard. A common way to trigger this process is via a defined sequence of button presses on the unprovisioned device. Step 2. Invitation. When the provisioner discovers the unprovisioned device via the beacons that were sent, it sends an invitation to this unprovisioned device. This uses a new type of PDU, also known as Protocol Data Unit, introduced in BLE Mesh, called the Provisioning Invite PDU. The unprovisioned device then responds with information about its capabilities in provisioning, which includes 1. The number of elements the device supports, 2. The set of security algorithms supported, 3. The availability of its public key using an out-of-bound technology, 4. The ability of this device to output a value to the user, 5. The ability of this device to allow a value to be input by the user. Step 3. Public key exchange. Security in BLE Mesh involves the use of a combination of symmetric and asymmetric keys, such as the elliptical curve Dive-Hellman algorithm. In ECDH, public keys are exchanged between the provisioner and the device to be provisioned. This is done directly over BLE or via an out-of-bound channel. Step 4. Authentication. The next step is to authenticate the unprovisioned device. This usually requires an action by the user by interacting with both the provisioner and the unprovisioned device. The authentication method depends on the capabilities of both devices used. In one case called the output OOB, the unprovisioned device could output a random signal or multiple digit number to the user in some form, such as blinking an LED a number of times. That number is then input into the provisioning device via some input method. Other cases include an input OOB, where the number is generated by the provisioner and entered into the unprovisioned device. Regardless of the authentication method used, the authentication also includes a confirmation value generation step and a confirmation check step. Step 5. Provision data distribution. After authentication is completed, each device derives a session key using their private key and the public key sent it to from the other device. The session key is then used to secure the connection for exchange of additional provisioning data, including the network key, a device key, a security parameter known as the IV index, and a unicast address which is assigned to the provisioned device by the provisioner. After this step, the unprovisioned device becomes known as a node. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.